Hey guys, this is Margot J. Rathbun. I'm certified as a nutritional therapy practitioner. I'm also the creator of AuthenticSelfWellness.com and a contributor for FitPres.com. So in this nutritional episode, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite teas. And as you know, I am a self-proclaimed teaholic. I love teas, especially green tea. But I want to talk to you about a very special kind of green tea and tell you about its health benefits. Now we're going to be talking about matcha tea. Now matcha tea has been used for thousands of years. It was traditionally a ceremonial tea used in Japan. And it's very special because it's grown in a different way than most of the other teas out there. It's actually shade grown, so it gets this beautiful dark color, which means it has more chlorophyll in it. And we'll talk about the health benefits of chlorophyll in a little bit. But it's actually the whole leaf of the tea in this little powder. You can see it's not like a regular loose leaf tea with the chunks of the leaves in it. It's an actual powder. And what happens is they grow this tea leaf under a shaded area, they pick the leaves, and then they stone ground it into this powder, and then they seal it up. So it's fresh, it's the whole leaf, you're getting all the nutrients inside the leaf, and it's delicious. Now, matcha is just like green tea as far as health goes, but it's almost amped up. It's been referred to as green tea on steroids. And in fact, one cup of matcha green tea has about 10 times the amount of antioxidants than regular green tea, so it's really good for keeping your immune system strong, giving you a nice natural lift of energy. It has 70 times the amount of antioxidants found in orange juice, and 9 times the amount of beta-carotene found in spinach, so it's really healthy. It also has powerful EGCG compounds, which have been known to help boost your immune system and prevent against cancer. Matcha also has antiviral and antibacterial properties, so it's going to help keep you well, especially during cold and flu season. It also helps with mental sharpness, with mental alertness, and it helps to calm you down. It kind of acts as a mood booster, but at the same time, it helps you relax. It's like a mood relaxant, and that's because it has an amino acid called L-theanine in it, and that just kind of helps promote a nice calm disposition. So like we said, it has a lot of chlorophyll because of the way it's grown. It's its deep, rich color. And chlorophyll has been shown to help remove heavy metals and toxins in the body. So it's a great tea to help you detox in a natural, healthy way. In addition to all this, matcha is full of potassium, it has iron, it has fiber, it's got a lot of vitamin A and vitamin C content, and it's very simple to make and use in your diet. So I got this matcha tea from Teavana. It's one of my favorite tea stores. And if there's not a Teavana store near you, you can go on their website and order it at Teavana.com. It's just under matcha tea, under the green tea tab. And let's talk about some of the ways that we can use matcha in our diet as opposed to just drinking it in the obvious sense as a tea. Now, I've gone ahead and I've made a matcha tea smoothie here. And all you need is one banana, about a cup of organic fresh blueberries, about a teaspoon of matcha tea, and you can also experiment and add maybe a little honey, some mangoes to get some added fiber, maybe a kiwi to get some vitamin C, and then you just mix it all up in your blender. I actually added about a cup of yogurt to it because I wanted to get some more protein and probiotics, and it's a delicious way to get the matcha tea into your system and have a good breakfast with the smoothie too. Now, if you're into sea salt, and I know I am, I use Celgree. It's a chunky sea salt, and all you do is take about 2 tablespoons of sea salt with about a teaspoon of matcha tea powder, and you just mix it up, and you see it gets this beautiful green color here, and you can use this on fish, on vegetables, it's great on eggs, and it's kind of fun for adding a nice sprinkle of color to your dishes. And sea salt is a much better alternative to regular salt because it has trace minerals in it. So you're getting the trace minerals and the antioxidants from the matcha tea. I also like to eat Greek yogurt in the morning. And as you can see, I've gone ahead and I've sprinkled some matcha tea powder on the top. It doesn't really have much of a taste difference. Just gives me a nice boost of antioxidants. It's an easy way to include it in your diet. So when it comes to making matcha tea, it's not like using a regular tea bag where you just steep it. What you do is you take your tea, and I'm going to use just about a teaspoon of this tea, and I'm using it in a clear bowl. I usually use it in a mug, or in Japan they use a ceremonial tea bowl, but I'm using it in a clear bowl just to show you guys. And sometimes there'll be little chunks of tea, and you can just smush it up like that with your spoon. And if they're really big, you can even add some cold water to make a nice matcha paste, which is going to make it easier to whisk. So what we're going to do is we're going to add, you want to add about a third cup of water just under a boil. I'm just going to add that much so you can see. And then you're going to take your whisk. I got this from Teavana. It's a bamboo whisk. And without touching the bottom, if possible, you're just going to whisk it. And you can go back and forth in an M motion to really get all those big bubbles to disappear. You want it to be kind of frothy with small bubbles. That's the best way to drink it. And it takes about 15 to 30 seconds to make the matcha to the point where you want to drink it. It's a good arm workout. And but the rewards are amazing. It tastes so good. It's a much better alternative to coffee. And you're going to get hooked. It just makes you feel so good. So as you can see there, it's a nice, beautiful green color. You can add as much water as you want, as less water. I tend to drink my matcha strong because I love strong tea. So it's a really great beverage, full of health benefits, very easy to make, and you're going to love it. So for more tips like these and different recipes that use matcha, be sure to visit my website, AuthenticSelfWellness.com. You can also follow me on Twitter @MargotRathbun. And as always, thank you for watching. Have a happy and a healthy day.